Save yourself a $3,000 compressor replacement by changing out this $24 capacitor piece. It's easy, you can do it yourself, and I'll show you how right now. Just remember, before doing any electrical on these units, take the breaker out. It is to code that all units must have a breaker within 3 feet of the compressor unit. This is the new one here. So all we have to do is pull the power plug, open up the corner. This is where your capacitor is. So now that's off, I have no power here. So the inside unit can run, this will not. You can see your wires coming in. So this is a panel I'm gonna take off. And voila. So here is where your old capacitor is. You can see this one's quite rusted on top. It's probably been here about 5-6 years, and it is time for it to go. It could still be good, but before it goes bad, because it could go within, it could last 2 years, it could last 3 months. I don't know. When it does go, the capacitor won't kick in and won't kick on the fan for one thing. So your compressor could overheat and burn out your compressor, or it's not enough to get your compressor going so you don't get any cold air in the house. It all depends on which part of the capacitor goes. One more thing that I generally do when I'm doing electric work, before you unplug anything, always snap a picture of it so you can realign it. If you screw up, you can always put it back. So next thing is, on these capacitors, there is a fan, a HERM, and a C for common. HERM is for hermetically sealed compressor unit. That's your fan, that's your common wire coming in. So you just gotta figure out which one is which, because I don't know by colors, because I'm not a professional. Actually, I am a professional. I already marked these ahead of time. That one's fan. And then we'll just slip the holder back on, put her back. And otherwise, that is it for this guy. Put our shield back on. There you go.